It's a sport, but it's a job. It's quite unique in the way that these people start very early in the morning. They do the training of the horses, they do their own training, they do the form, they have to ring for rides, and then they've got to go out and perform. We sometimes forget that they're only 16 and 17 and 18, they've only had a few race rides, but if someone's put their $5 on for them to win, if an owner's let them ride their horse, the stewards are watching from the tower, there's an expectation that they do everything right. And most of the time they do, and I think it's a great credit to them, their application that they put into this.
When did you decide that you wanted to be a rider?
Oh, I wanted to be a rider since term one, really.
One?
My dad is a jockey, so I've always been wanting to be one, you know. Everything's gone well at the moment, so hopefully it keeps going.
When you have a look at, obviously going to a very powerful stable, they get to ride a lot of horses and you have to earn your stripes there. There's no easy rides.
Exactly. It's a big competition. We've got good jockeys like Peter Nucky, Willie Pye, Peter Hall, fellow apprentice Joey that just come out of his time. So it's still a lot of competition.
You're obviously on song, but some of the strike rates are incredible. If you have a look at riding at Belmont Park, what do you think of Belmont?
Yeah, I love Belmont. It's I've outrode my 3 kilo claim on there. It's a pretty easy track to ride, which obviously once you figure it out, you can sort of come from everywhere. It's not really biased, but yeah, it's an all-round good track.
Your story is a bit different. You weren't born into a racing family, as far as I know. And how did you come to be a jockey?
I've always really wanted to be a jockey since I was little. I always used to just watch the races, but it just happened that I wasn't very good at school, and I just managed to get a bit of racing through school.
So take us back to when you're on the mechanical horse and you're learning how to ride and change those hands, etc. What race were you trying to win more than any other?
The Melbourne Cup.
That's good, mate.
I was pretty young then, so.
Well, it's good to dream. It's good to have that dream. What was the name of the horse? Can you tell us?
I actually didn't have one.
Was it a tight finish?
Nah, it wasn't.
You went easy. Over there, and did you have a lot of expectations?
Not really, I just pretty much just followed Lucy over there. And
she's come back.
Yeah, she got homesick, so she came home, and I had a bit of luck, so I decided to stay.
Well, you create your own luck in any game, and obviously, you've had a strong background in racing. You've watched your brothers come through, your dad, your mum, all very supportive of what you're doing. But being away from home, was there any homesickness for you?
Yeah, quite a bit. But when you're riding winners, it makes it a lot easier. So, just trying to make every place the winner at the moment and making the most of my opportunities. So, things are going well at the moment. I'll definitely stick it out to the spring and see where I go from there.